Hoi, ik ben Tom Lassing, beursbox.nl. Ik heb gesproken met Mart. Geen achternaam, is niet nodig om die te weten. Mart is de technische man van Ukraine Aid Ops. Dat is die hulporganisatie die hulp naar Oekraïne brengt. En Mart is de technische man. Hij is een droneontwikkelaar. En hij is dus bezig in Oekraïne om drones te testen, zodat die daadwerkelijk kunnen worden ingezet door het leger. Ik sprak hem, we hadden even de kans tussendoor en ja, dan kon ik hem even spreken, maar op dat moment had ik geen vragen paraat, dus het is niet mijn beste interview, het spijt me. Maar ja, het was al een gouden kans om dus iemand te spreken die zakelijk gezien drones ontwikkelt en die deels ook als hulpgoederen naar Oekraïne laat brengen. Ja, en die man is daadwerkelijk in Oekraïne bezig om dat voor elkaar te krijgen. Dus ik liet me die kans niet ontnemen, maar weet dat ik even met mijn bek vol mijn tanden stond in de zin van, wat moet ik hem nou vragen? Want ja, wat vraag je dan iemand die daarmee bezig is? Mijn excuus dat het niet mijn beste interview is, maar ik vond het toch belangrijk genoeg om hem eventjes te spreken. Hier komt het interview. Hi! How are you? And I'm so glad you have time to come to this webcast.
Yeah.
Can you
Thank
introduce
you.
Yourself, please?
Yes.
Yeah.
My name is Mart. I'm an Estonian guy who's been working with this Ukraine Aid Ops as well, the charity. But separately from the charity, I work as a drone producer as well. We have a drone producing company in Latvia, which produces drones for Ukraine. But yeah, in Ukraine Aid Ops, I've also been in charge of this drone expertise side.
Right. Is this fighting drones or surveillance drones?
Primarily, my focus has been on fighting drones. So these are single-use drones or drones which are bombers, but we have also looked at surveillance drones a little bit, but main focus is on fighting drones.
All right, and I hope you don't mind me asking, why are you in Ukraine? I know you make them for Ukraine, but what is your purpose to be in Ukraine at this moment?
At this moment, I'm in Ukraine because we are testing some of our company's products in Ukraine. We are visiting some testing polygons.
Yeah, you are in Ukraine to test. Is it testing on the battlefield or testing in just back?
So currently this is testing on polygons. We have sold our drones to Ukraine already, like our drones have been used in battle, but certain tests still have to be done. For example, for government level purchases, the governments want to have specific tests. So even if our drones are already used on the front line, that's not good enough. You still have to go and test them and get approval letters and bureaucracy all correct.
Okay, yeah, battle grades, and then of course they must be approved. Yeah, great. How much drones are we talking about? Is it hundreds? Is it thousands? How big are the drones?
So in our case, we make, let's say, hundreds or like low thousands of drones. So we currently have a little over 1,000 drones that we are like immediately able to sell. I know companies that are making a lot more drones in Ukraine, but we are comparatively, maybe like a small producer or a mid-sized producer. So definitely doing more than a couple guys in Irish can do, but not as many as some of these massive Ukrainian companies.
Yeah, well, everything helps, of course, so that is not a problem. And are those drones with the quad, the rotating?
Yeah,
or is it? Yeah, all right, okay.
Yes,
all right.
These are multi-rotor drones.
Yeah, and your company made them before the war, or is it all new?
So this is new. In our case, like my expertise and comes from looking at the situation in Ukraine, the war, the need for drones, the type of drones, how they have evolved over the war. So starting really from very early 2023. So as initially as part of the charity, we work to like support the troops that need the drones. And now like I've taken some of this experience and contacts in Ukraine and converted that into a company that makes drones that are relevant in Ukraine, because there are many different types of drones, but only so many drones are relevant in this war.
Yeah, and my webcast is transmitted in the Netherlands, and I always ask my viewers to give some money to the good cause. And how much would a drone set us back if we want to donate one?
I would say a typical cost of the drones in Ukraine is about 325-350 euros. So that is very, very affordable. And this is without battery. So I would say like altogether maybe 400-450 euros. Okay. And this is a capable drone that could take out the tank, you know. So that's why it's a very asymmetric war in many ways, that you can have three guys in a tank that cost 3 million euros and be threatened by three guys in a bush with 300 euros worth of drones. So
Yeah, that's incredible that it's possible to kill a tank with only a small drone. But yeah, that's and I asked the soldiers how they feel whether this war is winnable. You are in Ukraine. How do you see? How do you feel? You saw the people there. Do they think this war is winnable?
I think I heard soldiers as well before say like, "What is winnable, and what does winning look like?" I think it is winnable in the sense that Ukraine can achieve its like sovereign borders, get it back, simply because Russia is luckily also making a lot of mistakes, and they will exhaust themselves. So, you know, there's many sources regarding like how badly Russia loses its manpower as well as fighting vehicles and material. They are really spending it like there's no tomorrow, but unfortunately tomorrow always comes. So I think it's the main way of winning is basically wait until Russia exhausts itself, and then, you know, if we don't get exhausted as like Ukraine's allies, Ukraine will have that little bit extra left in the tank to win, because Russia will not be able to finance and supply its war machine. That's my opinion.
Okay. Yeah. Well, I'm glad you think that, because that's for me, winning this war will be get to the borders again and be able to say this is our land. And then go to NATO and please let us join NATO, because we kicked the Russians out. But it's never a plan for Ukraine to invade Russia, to conquer land, to keep it. So the best thing is try to get them out. And yeah, I do agree, Russia is killing itself more than it's being killed by Ukraine by mistakes that they make, and one of the mistakes I think Russia is making is they keep on pushing and losing a lot of stuff. And what you said, asymmetric, one tank 3 million against a drone that doesn't cost $1,000. So that is an unwinnable war if you can keep up the pace. And I'm glad you and your company keep up the pace and keep people coming. I hope that my viewers will be able to donate so that Ukraine is able, or Ukraine or the help organizations are able to buy those drones to give Ukraine the chance to win this war, whatever winning eventually is, because we can say a lot, but we don't know the future. Russia can collapse tomorrow, but it might be also possible that it takes 10 years. Estonia, Lithuania, I think they will try and push, but Hungary and maybe even Germany, I'm not sure they will be able to keep up the helping pace for another 6 years. So I'm glad you are there. I'm glad you helped them. Thanks very much from here. And I wish you well and have a great time over there. And keep up the good work. Thanks.
Thank you. Have a nice day.
Yes, thank you. Bye-bye.